Hello students, so last we are done with our exercise 8.1, on which we have already done with the question 1, 2, 3. Done? Okay, now let's moving towards the next question, which is question number 4. So the question is like that, study the slogan. So the slogan is given like the learning is fun, right? All are the capital letters. The question is asked like that which letter have perpendicular line. Then, so on that we have to find that ki isme se kaun se letters mein perpendicular lines aati hai. Then, so we know about the perpendicular line that ki agar usme line mein agar perfect capital L ban raha, line mein agar परफेक्ट कैपिटल एल बन रहा हो तो वो वाली लाइन को परपेंडिकुलर लाइन बोलते हैं. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस बाय वन ऑल द लेटर्स. देन ओके, सो ऑन दैट, सो फॉर द आंसर ऑफ ए वी कैन राइट the L, first letter is L, so we can write the L for that. Then, hello students, last we are done with the question number 1, 2, 3 of exercise 8.1. Then, okay, now let's moving towards the next one, which is question number 4. The question is like, study the slogan. So, the there is slogan is given which is in all capital letter, learning is fun. Then all are the capital letter, and after that there are four question is given on that. First one is which letter have perpendicular lines. Then so isme hame batana hai ki kaun se letters mein perpendicular line aati hai. So last mein maine aapko uski definition batai thi ki that line, the pair of the line which forms capital L letter, that type of line is called a perpendicular line. Then, okay. Exercise 8.1, question number 4, and that A1. So the answer, let's start from the first letter A. So in the L, first letter is only L, so L could be the answer. Then after E, so if you see the E, then I am drawing it bigger right now. So on that you can see that this line, then here this line is formed L, right? Over here is also L, here is also L, so we have three perpendicular, 1, 2, and 3, actually 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then so this can be also the answer. Then so E, next A. See, in the A, is there is any L you can find? No, in the A1 you cannot find. Then after R also we cannot find the L. Then after N, no, I is, there is only one line is there, so in this one it cannot be the perpendicular line. Then after again N, we cannot find the L. G, see, it is a capital G, it is like that. As you can see in this one, you can find the L over here, right? Over here you can find the L. Then so G is included in this one. Okay, next. Again, I not included. Then after it is S is given, which is like that. So in the S you can see that over here there is L is formed. Then, so S is also included in the answer. Then after S, F is there. If you see properly in the F, so there is the L, it is upside down L, right? So F is also included in this one. And after U is there, by making the U only you can see the L is over there. And then last N, so in the N we cannot get the answer. So the answer is, answer are L, E, G, S, F and U. So in this type of letter there are perpendicular lines. Then okay, next question number second. So the question number second is like, which letter have only one pair of parallel lines? So we need to find that type of letter which has only one pair of parallel line, right? L, there is no parallel line. Then after E, so if you draw the E, so it would be like that, right? So there is two pair of parallel line, 1, 2 and 3. Then so this cannot be included in the answer. A doesn't have a parallel line, R doesn't have a parallel line, and yes, N has a parallel line, this line and this line. Then so these two line could be the parallel line, and there is only one pair of line, so N included in the answer. Next, I not included. Next, then after N already counted, then after G, if you see the G, then there is also the parallel line, that is then if you see the G, then there is also parallel line over here and over here, but there are two pair of parallel line, 1 and 2. Then so G is also not included in the answer, right? Then after I, not included. S is also not included in the answer, because there it has a two pair of parallel line, 1, 2 and 3, right? Then after F, okay, if you see the F properly, you will get this type of shape. Then so in this one, if you see properly, then it has a one pair of parallel line, which is this. Then so F is included in the answer. Then after next letter U, let me erase this one. U, if you see the U properly, then you will get the one pair of parallel line, which are this. Then so here there is a pair of parallel line, so U is included in the answer. Next, N is also included. Then so this three only the answer of the second one. Then moving to the next question, question number C. Which letter has perpendicular line but not parallel line? So in this one, pay attention here. In this one, you just have to see those letter which has already perpendicular line, which means the answer of the A. Then, so in this one, you have to see that A. उसमें आपको क्या देखना है कि आपको ये देखना है कि किस लेटर में परपेंडिकुलर लाइन है, सब में है, बट सिर्फ और सिर्फ परपेंडिकुलर लाइन ही होनी चाहिए, पैरेलल लाइन नहीं होनी चाहिए. डन. सो दैट आंसर आई गिव इट टू यू. डन. दैट यू हैव टू डू इट बाय योरसेल्फ. सेम वे द लास्ट वन डी. व्हिच लेटर हैज ओनली वन पेयर ऑफ पैरेलल लाइन एंड टू पेयर ऑफ perpendicular line. Then, so this one also you have to do it by yourself, which is from all the letters you have to find that one pair of parallel line. Then, which are is this? Then, one pair of parallel line. So उसमें आपको directly कौन से letters देखना है, ये तीन, because इन तीन में ही सिर्फ one pair of parallel line है और एंड टू पेयर ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर लाइन, और दो पेयर आपको परपेंडिकुलर लाइन की फाइंड करनी है. देन व्हिच इज इन दिस वन ओनली. अंडरस्टूड? देन सो इन दिस वन आल्सो यू हैव टू डू फ्रॉम द बी, आंसर ऑफ द बी व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी डन ओवर हियर. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड? ओके, मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक व्हिच इज एंगल. सो व्हाट इज द एंगल? सो एंगल इज An angle is formed when two rays or straight line meet or intersect at one point. Say for example, we have this ray and this. Then, so here as you can see that two rays are meet. Let's take this ray as a OA and this one as a OB. So these two rays are meet at one point, which is O. Then, so at O the angle is formed, which we can make like that. This is the form. You can draw like that, that this is the angle which is formed at O. Then, okay, now let's talk about the line. So this is one straight line. This is another straight line. So this line, let's take name as AB, line AB and CD. So line AB and CD are intersect at point. Let's take Z. Then, so line AB and CD intersect at point Z. So over here the angle is formed. Then. So now we have to give the name of the components to form the angles. Then, so as you can see in this one, then जिसकी वजह से यहाँ पर एंगल फॉर्म हो रहा है. सो द मेन कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर दिस रे वन, दिस इज द वन रे, दिस इज द सेकेंड रे. सो दैट रे इज कॉल्ड आर्म्स ऑफ द एंगल. देन दिस इज कॉल्ड आर्म्स. देन इसको क्या बोलते हैं? आर्म्स बोलते हैं. देन देन दिस इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट हियर और हियर, देन सो दैट इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड द वर्टेक्स. क्या बोलते हैं इसको? वर्टेक्स. देन okay, so in this one we can say that OA and OB both are the arms and O is the vertex. Then next now let's say that how we can name this angle. Then so hum isko naam kaise de sakte hain? Always remember one thing, the vertex you have to name like that, that you have to include ऑल द थ्रीज, मीन्स आर्म्स, दोनों आर्म्स भी आपको इंक्लूड कर लेने हैं एंड वर्टेक्स ऑल्सो यू हैव टू इंक्लूड. देन सो रिमेंबर वन थिंग, वर्टेक्स यू हैव टू पुट इन टू द सेंटर, मीन्स आपको बीच में रखना है उसको. देन सो द नेम ऑफ दैट एंगल वी कैन राइट एज अ एंगल then angle BOA. As I said, you have to put the vertex in the middle of both of the arms. Understood? Then, so this is the arm, this is the arm. You can name like that BOA. So, iske include jo bhi aata hai, that is our angle. Okay, let's take one more example for that. Then, let's say this is the one ray, this is another ray. Take this ray as a QP and this one as a QR, right? So, and this one, as you can see that, and over here the angle is formed, then here the angle is formed, then these are the arms of it. Again, I am revising it. These are the arms of it. This point Q is called the vertex. Then this point is called the vertex of it. Okay, now there is a two way to naming the angle. Then first we can start from this arms. We can start from this arms means P से भी हम start कर सकते हैं and we can start from this arms also. Then okay, let us first see the what is the notation or what is the sign for the angle. This is the sign for the angle. Then first we have to start from this, then after we have to write that name of it. Then so this called the angle. Then so we can write like a PQR. So the angle PQR, then this is the one way, or we can also write by starting this arm, angle R Q and P. Understood? We can also write like a R Q P. Understood? Then remember, in this one also you have to remember only one thing, which is you have to put the vertex into the middle of the both arms. Then understood? Okay, now here we are done with the angles. So there are some property of the angle, which is what is called the interior of the angle and what is called the exterior of the angle. Then so it is simple only. Then if you stretch both the ray, then so it will expand like that. Then so iske andar mein jitna bhi aata hai, means this all the area, means iske andar jo bhi ho, points ho, lines ho, then so all the things are included in the interior of the angle. Then wo sare ki sare cheez, say for example here I have a point A. So point A is included in the interior of the angle. And if I have a here, over here, the point B, then so point B is included in the exterior of the angle. Interior means andar ka, or exterior means angle ke bahar ka. Understood? Then so that is called the interior and exterior of the angle. If you can see that, let's take one more example for that. If I have a point C over here, point D over here, so C is included in the interior of the angle and D is included in the exterior of the angle. Understood? Then again, now let's take the, there are so many types of angle. We can differentiate into three types, mainly three types of angle. Then so there this differentiation is done by the degree. Then ki wo degree ke comparison mein usko hum differentiate kar paaye. Then that is called, the first one is the acute angle. Then
ahead. Then, so first, what is the acute angle? Acute angle, it means that the value of, if the value of the angle is less than 60, less than 90 degree, then when the value of the angle means less than 90 degree, so that type of angle is called an acute angle. Then let's take if this is the angle and the measure, let's take less than 90, 60 degree, then so this is the 60 degree angle, so this type of angle is called an acute angle. It means that the range for the acute angle is 0 to 90, 90 is not included in this one, understood? So again I am repeating the definition for the acute angle, that it is an angle whose measure lies between 0 to 90 degree. Then, and in this one, remember one thing, 90 is not included, understood? So this type of angle is called the acute angle. Next, let's take one more type, second type, which is right angle. Then right angle, then so this type of angle we have already seen. So it is called an angle measurement whose an angle whose measurement is 90 degree, an angle whose measurement is particularly 90 degree. So that type of angle is called an right angle. Then, so for the right angle, the also there is a sign is also different. Then, as you can see that this is for sign for the 90 degree, and this type of angle we have already seen, which we call in the line a perpendicular line, right? So at the perpendicular line there is a right angle is there. Understood? Then. So for the normal angle the sign would be like that, then but for the right angle is 90 degree angle, the sign is like that. Then so again I am repeating the definition for it, an angle whose measurement is equals to 90 degree is called a right angle. Then okay, next let's differentiate third type of angle, which is obtuse angle. Okay, so now it is easy to remember this includes the range 0 to 90 degree, then this is particularly equal to 90 degree, so obviously this is greater than 90 degree. Then so an angle whose measurement is between 90 to 180, so that type of angle is called a obtuse angle. Say for example, okay, as you can see this is more than the 90 degree, then let's take just as a 150 degree, then so this type of angle is called a obtuse angle. Then, so the range for that is 90 to 180. Then, understood? Okay. Now moving towards the next exercise, which is 8.2. Then. Okay, so on that one there are three questions are given. Yeah. One by one I am explaining all the questions to you, that that what type of questions are there, that all the questions you have to do in your homework. Before that let me explain them to you. Then so the first question is like that, which of the following figures represent an angle? Then so in this one you have to just see that ki kis
फिगर में एंगल बन सकता है. देन सो देर आर वेरियस टाइप ऑफ फिगर इज गिवन, यू जस्ट हैव टू सी दैट दैट इज देर एनी टू रेज और द लाइंस विच विल इंटरसेक्ट और मीट एट सम पॉइंट. If they are meeting or if they are intersecting at some point, then so there is the chance to make an angle. Then so there are different type of questions are there. I am just taking example of them. I am not taking the same questions. Okay, then because that type of questions you have to do in your homework only. Then okay, let's take example of some. Figure of some lines or rays. Okay, I have one ray over here. This is the second ray. Okay, is there is any chance to make or to meet this two rays? No. If we extend this ray can be extended in this side, this ray can be extended in this side. So there is no chance to make an angle. Then let's take one more example. Then one ray, second ray. Okay, is there is any chance that these two rays make an angle? Let them extend. Okay, if we extend this, so this will be goes this side probably, and if we extend this, so this will be goes to that side. Then so yes, there is a chance they meet or they intersect at one point. Then so, and from this one we can make an angle. Then let's take one more example. Let's take the example for the line this time. Okay, okay, is there is any chance in this two line that they will intersect at some point? No. Why? Because they are the parallel line, and we know that in the parallel line they will never meet. Then okay, so based on them, that you need to figure out in which figure. There are four questions are there, A, B, C, D, and you just have to answer as A. In the A one, there is a possibility of represent an angle. In B, there is a possibility. That's it. Okay, next question number second. So on that, the question is like that: in given figure, you have to name the angle. You have to the second question, you have to name the vertex and the arms of the angle. Then after there are the points are given. So on that you have to say that which points are interior of the angle and which points are exterior of the angle. Then so I am taking another example. Then pay attention here. I have taken another example. This is not the same as the second one. Done, because second one you have to do in your homework. Okay, so I am giving the name of this as a, let's take this as a P, this one Q, this one R. Let's take some points. Let's take this point as a X. This over here. Let's take outside. Select this as a Z. Okay, so first, as per the second question, so in this one, first I have to name that angle. Then, so the angle, before that, you need to figure out which is the vertex. Then, because I have already told you that you have to put the vertex in the middle of the arm. Then, so as you can see, this is the vertex, Q is the vertex. Then so there is a
two ways to name the angle. Angle, this is the sign of it. Angle, you can start from P, P, Q, R. Angle P, Q, R. Or you can reverse it also. Angle, you can start from R, R, Q, P. Angle R, Q, and P. Understood? Next, let's take second one, B. Vertex and the arms of the angle. So we have already described that vertex is Q, and the arms. Arms are OQP and QR. Then, so this is the vertex, and this both are arms. Then, next, the point in the interior of an angle. So, as you can see in this one, there are two points in the interior of the angle, which is X and Z. And so, you can write that point X and point Z. B, Y, there should be the answer, because on that one we need to find that the point in the exterior of the angle. So there is one point, which is point Y. Then, okay, so this way you can answer all the questions of the question number second. Then, remember, this is example. This is, I just take the example. The actual question is something different. Then, so that you have to do it by yourself. And then after next, there are the question number 3, which is we have already done over here, which is the type of the angle. Then, so on that, you just have to differentiate that which type of angle is this. The question is like, classify the angle as a right angle, acute angle, and obtuse angle. Then, so you just have to classify that figure A. In the figure A, is there is a the acute angle or right angle or obtuse angle. So when you see the figure, if the angle is between 0 to 90, your answer would be acute angle. If the angle is 90, then your answer would be right angle. If the angle is more than 90, means 90 to 180, then your answer would be obtuse angle. Then, so that's how you have to answer then. Understood? Then, so today's your homework is exercise 8.2, question 1, 2, 3. Then, and one question which is of exercise 8.1, question 4, C and D. Then, question 4 mein jo C or D hai, wo aapko karna hai. And exercise 8.2, question number 1, 2, 3. Then, thank you.